start. My name is Todd Scott, the Supervisor of Transportation for Beavercreek City Schools. I'd like to welcome you all here to Main Elementary for this celebration. It is my privilege to welcome all of you here tonight as we come together to honor those who have given so much to our country and our freedoms, our veterans. Members of the Transportation Department have each requested a quilt of valor for a family member or a friend who was called to serve our great nation. In conjunction with the Miami Valley Quilters Guild in Fairborn, we award these quilts tonight to say thank you for the sacrifices that each of them has made to keep our country safe. We are very appreciative of your attendance and your willingness to join us on this very special occasion. At this time, we have Miss Debbie Ginsburg, who is going to play the national anthem, and we have 4 8th grade students from Ankeny Middle School: Alyssa Ennis, Megan Evans, Preston Haynes, and Curtis Lemieux. I'd like to ask you to come up to the stage. They're going to sing the national anthem for us. At this time, I'd like all of you to remove your hats and please rise to honor our great nation.
We also make community quilts for area hospitals and shelters. We hold retreats and classes, and throughout the year, we will have local as well as national speakers who help us expand our knowledge. One of our major projects is our quilt show, which is coming up in May 2016, and we hold that at the Greene County Fairgrounds in Xenia. We thank you all for joining us tonight as we honor those who have served our country to protect our freedoms. We are greatly indebted to these veterans, and we want to show them our appreciation with what we love to do. Make quilts and give them away. Thank you.
I'm Debbie Ginsburg. Pittsburgh. I'm the Quilts of Valor project coordinator for the Miami Valley Quilters Guild. Tonight is the culmination of practically a year's worth of planning, sewing, and organizing. Many of you might not have heard of Quilts of Valor until you received an invitation for tonight, so I'd like to give you a little bit of the background. The National Quilts of Valor organization is a national grassroots community service effort that began in 2003 by a Blue Star mom named Catherine Roberts, who wanted to do something for her son while he was deployed. The goal is to cover all returning servicemen and women touched by war. Quilts of Valor are stitched with love, prayers, and healing thoughts. They are a tangible reminder of an American's appreciation of your for the answering of your country's call. Since its beginning, over 127,000 Quilts of Valor have been awarded to active military and veterans. So as Sherry said, during the last 3 years, the Miami Valley Quilters Guild has been very active with Quilts of Valor. We have had block drives, sew-ins, and lots of individual sewing and quilting. All the fabric that goes into a Quilt of Valor has been donated from our membership. Over 50 members have been directly involved in the making of the 19 quilts that you will see tonight, and many others volunteer indirectly through their donations and their support. Counting tonight's quilts, we have awarded 90 quilts in the last 3 years to veterans and active military who have been touched by war. Connie Combs, who works in the Beavercreek City Schools Transportation Department, has been instrumental in helping to organize this evening's program. When she came to me many months ago and handed me 20 requests for Quilts of Valor from the Transportation Department, I have to admit I was a little overwhelmed. But what an honor this is for our guild to be able to make and award these quilts. It is a labor of love for all of us, and so little compared to what all of these veterans on stage have sacrificed. This is our first group presentation, and of course you learn a lot along the way. So please forgive us if we mispronounce your name, if we've got your rank wrong, or if we mess up in any other way. Just let us know after the program and we'll try to do whatever we can to make it right. I have learned a lot about military ranks in the last couple of months. So now, the awarding of the quilts. Each of these quilts is completely different and unique. Our group is very diverse in ages and abilities, and these quilts show the wide variety of our interest in our fabric collection. You will also receive a letter thanking you for your service, a pillowcase, the quilt is labeled with your name, and a Quilt of Valor designation. So I would like to read a portion of the letter that you will all receive at this time. The Miami Valley Quilters Guild and Fair Board and the Beavercreek City Schools Transportation Department would like to thank you for your service to our country. This Quilt of Valor is being awarded to you to honor your sacrifice in helping to keep our country safe and to protect our freedoms. We hope that this Quilt of Valor will bring you honor and comfort and healing. Please use it in your everyday life, and may it be a remembrance of our gratitude. God bless. As you know, most people use it on the recliner watching the ball games, so that's fine. So when I call your name, please come forward right here, and our ladies on stage will show your quilt to the audience, then to those rest of you on stage. We will come wrap the quilt around you, and then you can return to your seat. And be sure to pick up your pillowcase and the letter from our ladies after the program. So we're going to go in alphabetical order. So Corporal Donald Lee Adams, U.S. Army, was nominated by Ben Adams. Right here. You get to lead the way and show everybody how to do it. Thank you. office staff.
Thank you.
nominated by Lynn McCoy. Charles N. Nichols, United States Air Force, who is also not able to be here tonight, but we'll make sure that he gets his quilt also. E6 Charles Roach Jr., United States Air Force, nominated by Lori Roach. We also want to extend our appreciation to the area quilt stores who support us, Solot in Centerville, Mason Jar Quilt Shop in Enon, Sulphur Grove Quilt Shop in Huber Heights, and especially Jennifer Davis and the Little Shop of Stitches in Miamisburg, who graciously donates her classroom for us to have our sewing days. And we have a photo area set up behind this curtain where you all can bring your quilts back here. I want your families and friends to come back. We can have a place where we can hang your quilt, have your pictures taken with your families and friends. We have people that will use your cameras if you want, so everybody can get in the getting the picture, and they can have pictures taken with their favorite veteran. So please take advantage of this, as we know these pictures can be wonderful remembrances of this evening. So please have a safe trip home, and thank you again for your presence.